Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Steele, the High Level Queen, and in this video, I have an exciting announcement. The folders and search feature for the email builder that everyone has been waiting for is now live, so I'm gonna show you how to organize your email builder and what happened to all of your HTML emails. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. All right. So where did your emails go? Because a lot of you I know had them in the HTML builder, the super old school thing that was super clunky to use and awkward for everybody. So as of the 22nd of February, all of your emails should be in the brand new email builder in the marketing tab. So you're gonna click on marketing and then email builder, and you'll be able to see all of your emails here. And if they were migrated over by High Level, they will have a new updated date, okay? Now, my favorite thing about what they did with this was not only that they migrated them all for me, but that I can now create folders to move my things into. So I'm going to create a test folder. And they only show 7 results on this, so that was also awkward as well because you had to keep hitting next. So I'm going to do a test folder, and I'm going to do a Shopify folder. And now you'll see it's been ordered alphabetically, and I can actually go in here and just click move to folder. There you go. It's been moved. Okay, so I just moved 2 in it. Now it says I have 2 emails in the Shopify folder. And then let's say I want to move this one into the test folder. So now I have 1 in there and 2 in here. Now I can simply click and see my emails in here. And if I accidentally moved them to the wrong folder, I can move them back out of the folder by clicking move to root folder, or I can move them into the test folder accordingly. So now it's in the test folder. I'm gonna move it back into the Shopify folder. Look at that. Now you can also do a search, okay? So let's say that I have a million emails in here because in my main account I do, and I'm like, okay, well, what was that one email where I talked about Shopify? Oh, look at that. It pulled up both the emails that have Shopify in the title. And I can go over here and I can type test, and it fell in the folder also. So it finds the folders and the emails. Isn't that cool? Now, if you want to simply open it, if it's the new format, you'll see this. If it's the old format, you'll see HTML here. And what happens when you open it, it's actually going to pull up the HTML so you can't actually drag and drop it if it was the old school one. But you can simply change the HTML on the left-hand side. So let's say that I want to add a link to some text. So like if I see over here, typical nerd stuff. So I'm going to do a control F. I'm going to look for nerd stuff here. So you can see that here. So if I want to add a link, I'm gonna do a bracket A, href, and then close the bracket, and this is like basic HTML slash A to close it. And then you can see over here that I just hyperlinked that there, okay? Now I'm gonna go ahead and exit because I don't want to save that, but you can send a test email, review and send. You can see what it looks like on mobile, desktop. Then you can do your settings in here, your from, name, address, etc. Or you can do it in the workflow. but if you make any changes, you're going to want to save those. Okay, so it does look different if your emails were migrated in and you can't drag and drop them anymore. But for me, I'm okay with it because HTML is pretty easy and I don't really need to change those. So going forward, you can use the brand new email builder to drag and drop. So let's say that I want to make a new email. I'm going to go to my test folder and then I'm going to make a new email. And they give you all these templates to choose from now. So I'm going to click on simple. And now I can literally drag and drop images, videos, text, code, even RSS, which is kind of crazy. I've had another video on how to do that. RSS feeds on your blog, and then the footer here. So the new email builder is awesome, and I hope this helps you guys. Don't forget to sign up for your free trial using the link below so you get your bonuses, and like and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos from me, and I'll see you next time.